Amen. For I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, giving him praises and thanksgiving. What time is it, people of God? It's time for Bible study. Amen. Time for our youth Bible study on the day. On behalf of everyone that's here, Pastor Allyssa, Apostle Allyssa, yes, and me, myself, I want to say thank you and welcome for listening. Thank you for listening to us.
Amen.
If we could start off with a moment of prayer.
Amen. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we just go before your throne of grace, Heavenly Father. We ask that you will administer a word to your people, Heavenly Father. We ask that you would give them a word, Heavenly Father, that would encourage them on the day, Heavenly Father. What is a leader, Heavenly Father? You caused each and every one of us to be a leader on the day. You called us to lead. You said that we ought to lead and not follow. We ought to be a lender and not a borrower. And if we're lenders, then we're leading. So in the mighty name of Jesus, we invite your precious spirit into the Bible study on this evening. We ask that you would just simply have your way. We ask that you would give us words of encouragement that will increase our faith in the mighty, precious name of Jesus. We thank God even right now. Hallelujah and amen. Amen.
Amen. As she said, what is a leader? Amen.
Yes.
We're talking about leadership on today. Amen.
Yes.
In our world, in our society today, leaders are needed. Amen.
Amen.
To come up and come forth. Amen. But what does leadership have to do with the kingdom of God on this evening? Amen. What does leadership have to do? Why does God call us to lead? Amen. Why does God call us to lead his sheep and his flock? Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If we could start off, I'll be reading from Hebrews chapter 11, starting at verse 1.
Amen.
And it reads, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For Amen. By it the elders obtained a good report. Mm-hmm. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Amen. May the Lord have a blessing to the reading of his word. Amen. What is this saying on today? Amen. For it says in verse 2, for the elders obtained a good report. Amen.
Yes.
The elders are mentioned, hallelujah, Jesus, throughout the Bible. Amen. And what are the elders? Elders were leaders. Amen.
Yes.
They were the leaders of the people. Amen.
Yes.
It says that the elders obtained a good report through their faith. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Verse 4, it reads, by faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it he being dead yet speaketh. Amen.
Amen.
Cain and Abel, amen, they were brothers in the beginning of the Bible. Amen.
Yes.
For it says that Abel offered a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. Amen.
Yes.
What did Abel do? Amen. He became up as a leader. Amen. He was a leader for his family, for his brother. Amen. He set the standard, amen. He gave God a more excellent sacrifice, amen, which made him a leader. And what are leadership skills, amen? What do leaders do, amen? Leaders have to come up amongst the group, amen, come up amongst the kingdom, the people, amen, to lead the people, amen. For we talked about before, without a vision, there is a division, amen. And what do leaders do? They see beyond, amen. They see beyond the, hallelujah, Jesus, the plan, amen. They see beyond what is supposed to be doing, amen. They see the big picture, amen. They see what everyone's supposed to be doing, amen. They keep everybody together so that they are not led astray, amen.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Leaders keep everything together, amen. What would we do without leaders, amen? Who would be there to keep us in check, to make sure that we're doing everything that we're supposed to, amen?
Yes.
Leaders in the church, amen. The pastor, amen, or the director of service, amen, the leader of the choir, amen. On Sundays, amen, they come in and they just, for example, they come in and make sure that all the sound is set up, make sure that the sound is together so that when the minister comes up, everything runs smoothly, amen. They make sure that the programs and the order of service are together, amen. They make sure the church is all together and kept nice and clean, amen. Leaders are there. They come up amongst, amen,
amen,
the people, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen. I just want to add, if I could add also, that it reminds me a lot of, you know, there being a leader inside of us, because David was a man that was a leader.
Yes.
When we look at David, even though he was a youth, he was still yet a leader, because here we have David who is, he couldn't have been no more than 12 or 13 years old. And he stands up and he stands up and he gives courage. And he says, you know what, I believe that I can take on on this Philistine. Why? Because the Spirit of the true and living God has given me the power to be able to conquer this Goliath. And so when we look at David's life and the leadership that was found in David, David had courage. Amen. David trusted in God. Why? Because God was with David when he, what did the scripture say? He fought off, what was it? The lion and the bear.
Amen. When David had to face Goliath, amen. He yes. told the people in the army, they said that he couldn't do it. He said, if I can fight off the bears and the tigers, amen, then Goliath is nothing.
Amen. 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 Thank you very much. And so Goliath, amen, Goliath no longer was David's enemy because, well, Goliath no longer became David's enemy. He became his footstool. Amen. Why? Because David had the courage. Amen. And when we're faced with opportunities to lead, amen, even as a youth or as a young adult, amen, God will give us the courage, amen, that we need in order to conquer the battle. So even as we lead, we're not in it by ourselves. Amen. I just hear the Spirit of the Lord saying to tell Sierra, amen, that we're not in it by, she's not in it by herself, amen. This is a prophetic ministry, amen, and we just go by how the Lord says to go, amen. So, amen, take us into the Word, Sierra, amen.
Amen. Verse 5, we're still in Hebrews chapter 11, and it reads, by faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death.
Yes.
And was not found because God had translated him.
Yes.
For before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God.
Amen.
But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's saying without faith, it is impossible to please him. Amen.
Yes.
And we know sometimes, amen, we don't come fully prepared. Amen.
Yes.
Sometimes we don't have everything together. Either it was just short notice or we procrastinated. This is youth Bible study at school. Maybe you weren't ready for the presentation or the PowerPoint. Nothing is coming together. Amen. You had everything set out. You had it all on a flash drive, all sent where it was supposed to be. And then when it's yes. time to present or time to give the information, hallelujah, Jesus, it's just not ready, amen?
Amen.
And what do we say? We have to wing it, amen? When yes. we can, when we aren't prepared and we don't have it together, hallelujah, Jesus, we have to wing it, amen?
Amen.
For sometimes that's where the faith steps in, amen, is when we have to wing it, amen, hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Faith steps in when we have to wing it. We say, I have faith that I will get it together, hallelujah, Jesus. I have faith that I will see the big picture, hallelujah, Jesus. I will have faith that I will be a leader, hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
I will be the leader of the group. I will be the leader of the people. And yes. I'm standing on God. As she said, you're not standing alone, amen.
Yes.
That faith that she had, amen.
Yes.
For faith saved us, hallelujah, Jesus. Faith kept yes. us together, for we are kept by grace. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Without faith, it is impossible to please him. Hallelujah, Jesus. And Hebrews 11, verse 7, we're still in it, reads, by faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness, which is by faith. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed. And he went out not knowing whether he went.
Amen.
May the Lord have a blessing to the reading of his word.
Amen.
So as it is saying, amen, it's just going through the Bible and it's giving testimonies of people throughout the Bible that had faith. Hallelujah. Just that stepped out as a leader in faith.
Yes.
Noah stepped out as a leader. Amen. As we've heard in the classic story that the world, Adam and Eve were multiplying in the world. Everyone was corrupt. No one was doing the things that God wanted them to do.
Yes.
And Noah stepped out and became that leader. He was the only right. righteous one. Him and his family, hallelujah, Jesus, God saw mercy on them.
Yes.
That they may live when God brings the flood.
Amen.
Noah being warned of God. This is how I was saying that the faith ties in. How you're not by yourself, how God is on your side. When you ask God to come in, for the Bible says that we have not because we ask not. Amen.
Yes.
Ask and it shall be given unto you. For Solomon asked
yes.
for wisdom and God gave him, and he is still the wisest man ever known. Excuse me.
Yes.
Noah came out as a leader. Hallelujah. When you have God on your side, God will see through, amen. Yes. For we're being warned of God, amen. God showed Noah, amen. For many times we see in movies or in TV shows, we say, I need a sign, amen.
Yes.
God showed Noah a sign, a warning. When yes. you have God on your side as a leader, God will show you warning so that you
Preach.
Can guide his sheep in the group directly.
Yes.
Not by your own self, not by your own sight, amen. For when Jesus went to pray, amen, with his disciples before the soldiers, hallelujah, Jesus, the Pharisees and Sadducees came to come to take him to jail, hallelujah, Jesus. He prayed, amen, and he
yes.
said, not your will, not my will, but your will be done, amen.
Yes.
And that's what that faith ties in, as she was saying that, when she was saying that, hallelujah, Jesus, that you're not there by yourself. God will send you
yes.
the warning so that you can guide and direct him, amen. If I could say amen and keep it real,
yes.
God, out there looking a fool, hallelujah, Jesus,
amen.
He's gonna keep you there, hallelujah,
amen.
Jesus, to guide the sheep, amen, to
yes.
guide his people so that it may go the way, the will, and the way that he wants it to go according to his plan and his purpose. Apostle, is there anything that you would like to add to
amen.
That?
Amen, praise the Lord. I just want to say that, amen, you did a wonderful job at handling that word and expressing what God was saying, and what God was saying was that she is not alone. And so as she is not alone, you're not alone, and I am not alone. Why? Because God will give you everything that it is that you need. If you're looking to go out and you're looking to lead something, and you're looking to, amen, to spearhead something or cause something to happen, God will give you everything that you need, because God gave Noah the wood. Amen. God told Noah to go out and get the gopher wood. Amen. God gave Noah everything that he needed. He gave him all of the supplies. He even gave him the measurements. So this is the type of God that we serve. He will give you everything that you need as he calls you to be a leader. Why? Because it's a part of his plan. It's a part of his purpose. And your life is not your own. Amen. And so the Bible goes on to say, amen, go ahead and take us to the verse, Sierra.
Hebrews, as we've been in chapter 11, verse 9, and it reads, by faith he sojourned in the land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, and heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked for a city which had foundation, whose builder and maker is God. Through faith also Sarah received her strength to conceive seed, and was delivered of a child when she was past age, because she judged him faithfully who he had promised. Therefore sprang there even of one, and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the seashore, innumerable. Amen. What is
Amen.
This talking about? It's talking about how it says Sarah, hallelujah, Jesus, received the strength that she was saying.
Yes.
You're not there alone by yourself. You have someone to lean on, someone to hold on to when you can't stand up by yourself. God had gave her the strength to conceive seed when Sarah was almost 100 years old.
Amen.
God gave her the strength to be able to have that seed. And God promised Abraham, as it was saying in verse 12, and as the sand which is by the seashore, innumerable. Amen. This is saying that God promised Abraham that he would have more seeds, hallelujah, Jesus, than the sand that is numbered on every seashore throughout
Amen.
The whole entire world, hallelujah, Jesus. We're all seeds of Abraham. Amen.
Yes.
This is the faith that we're talking about in leadership. Amen. How can I step out and be a leader, God? As she was saying, no matter how young you are, amen, we think that leaders, hallelujah, Jesus, have it together, amen.
Amen.
As we talked about, hallelujah, Jesus, last week on Wednesday, you have
yes.
to get the message, go to her page on Facebook, hallelujah, Jesus,
amen.
Allyssa Narvaez, you'll see it there. We
amen.
Were talking about how we see people, amen.
Yes.
We think that the people who have it all nice together, they're groomed very nicely. They're not dirty. They're very clean. They have the nice suit on or the nice dress. They look nice. Like everything was expensive. Hallelujah, Jesus. They have nice and they're manicured. The jewelry, everything is matching. Their hair is well groomed. Their
Amen.
Shoes are shining and they look nice. They think that this is what the leaders are supposed to look like. Hallelujah, Jesus. But we were talking about how the Lord takes the weaker things of the world to confound the wise.
Yes.
Just as she was talking about David, amen. He was the younger one, amen. And he confounded the wise, even the wise people inside the army, hallelujah, Jesus, were yes. confounded by David's age, amen. Yes. Age is nothing, hallelujah, Jesus. God can work with you at any age, amen.
Yes.
For Hannah in the Bible, she couldn't have a child, but when she was blessed with the child, God, she said that she promised God that she would take him to the temple, amen. And yes. as we read in the story, it says that her son, that he would cry, that Jesus would call his name, and yes. he would go to the elder, he would go to the priest, and he would say, yes. have you called me? Yes. And he says, no, I have not called you. Go back to bed. And it happened 2 times. And finally, the priest said, if it calls you again,
yes.
say, yes, Lord, what is it that you have me to do? Amen.
Yes.
He
yes.
was a leader. He came out as being young. Amen.
Yes, yes, that's Samuel.
Amen, that is Samuel. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God. See right there, somebody to lean on. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus. A leader. Jesus.
Amen.
Samuel, Jesus. If we can keep reading, amen, it reads, hallelujah, Jesus, in verse 13, it says, these all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off and were persuaded of them and embraced them and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth.
Amen.
For they that say things declare plainly that they seek a country. And truly, if they had been mindful of that country from whence they came out, they might have an opportunity to have returned. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus. May the Lord have a blessing to the reading of his word.
Amen.
The Bible is saying, amen?
Yes.
That leaders, hallelujah, Jesus, many leaders in the Bible came out to seek a country. Amen?
Yes.
If we could take, hallelujah, Jesus, the children of Israel, for instance. Amen?
Yes.
And I have a verse to go along with that. If we could go over to Numbers 27.
Amen.
Chapter
Praise
27.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus, that the people of Israel, hallelujah, Jesus, they were brought out of slavery. Moses brought them out of slavery. Hallelujah, Jesus. Moses,
yes.
as we were talking about, he became a leader. Amen.
Yes.
And when God came to him into the burning bush, he said, please take my, hallelujah, Jesus, we're going to go to verse 15.
Amen.
He said, God said, I need you to go and tell Pharaoh to let my people go.
Yes.
And Moses said, I cannot, for I cannot speak. Amen. In so many words, he was saying that I stutter, Lord. I cannot speak in front of all these great people. And he said, I will send you Aaron. Amen.
Yes.
Even though we may not have everything that we're equipped with. Amen.
Yes.
God provided us, she was saying. He provided Noah with the measurements of the ark and for the wood, the ark that he needed. Amen.
Yes.
We're in Numbers chapter 27, verse 15, and it reads,
amen.
And Moses spake unto the Lord, saying, let the Lord, the God of the spirits and all of the flesh, set a man over the congregation. Amen. Just we could pause for a second. If I could give a quick, hallelujah, Jesus, a background so that we know what we're talking about.
Amen.
As I was saying, after Moses brought the people of Israel out of slavery, Moses had passed along, and another man, hallelujah, Jesus, Joshua, had came up to be the leader, and the people of Israel needed a new place, hallelujah, Jesus. It was saying before in Hebrews, it was
Amen.
Saying that
Take
the people
your time.
Needed a new country, hallelujah, Jesus,
yes.
somewhere to stay. So Joshua came up as a leader, and it says, verse 16, let the Lord, the God of spirits of all flesh, set a man over the congregation, a leader, hallelujah, Jesus, which may go
yes.
out before them, and which may go in before them, and which may lead them out, and which may bring them in, that the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep which have no shepherd. Let me read
Amen.
That one more time.
Take your time.
Because I need you to get this in your spirit. We're
yes.
talking about leadership on this evening. Verse
yes.
27, we're still in, I'm sorry, Numbers chapter 27, verse 17, it reads, which may go out before them, and which may go in before them, and
yes.
which may lead them out, and which may bring them in.
Yes.
That the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep which have no shepherd. Amen.
Yes.
As this is saying, amen.
Yes.
Moses said, he says, I know I'm going to go, Lord God. I know that it's time for me to die. I know that I'm in my old age. And ask
yes.
Lord, amen, over congregation. We need a leader, Lord, to lead these people so that they may not be as sheep which have no shepherd, amen.
Yes.
As we have heard many times, the pastor, hallelujah, Jesus, of the church is the shepherd, amen, which leads the flock to the sheep, hallelujah. For he was a shepherd, he kept the sheep, hallelujah, Jesus. He kept the sheep, hallelujah, Jesus, from, hallelujah, Jesus, the lions and the tigers, as they were saying, amen, and the bears. that he protected them for, which may go before them and which may go in before them, and which may lead them out and which may bring them in. Amen?
Yes.
As we are reading, amen, it's time to read in between the lines. Hallelujah.
Come on now.
Moses was asking the Lord, hallelujah, yes, Lord, to set a leader, and I need a leader. He was giving specific sets of rules, amen. He didn't just stop at verse 16 and said, set a man over the congregation. He said, what kind of man? He said he needed a man that would go before them, that would go in and lead them out, hallelujah, Jesus. He needed a man that would bring them in and bring them out, one that would take them in and take them out, one would go before them and go behind them. Hallelujah, Jesus, we need someone to be there.
Amen.
To take care of them, amen. For Moses was taking care of his flock, taking care of his sheep. He said, Lord, I don't want any old leader coming up and taking care of my flock, but I need somebody who's going to lead them the way that you would want them to lead. I need somebody who's going to guide their.
Yeah.
And which, verse 18, take thee Joshua, the son of Nun, a man whom is, hallelujah, Jesus, if you have your Bibles, is in italics, amen. And what does that mean? Italics mean that it's important. And Bible says you need to get this out in your spirit.
Amen.
And the Lord says, well, take Joshua, the son of Nun, amen, who is the spirit. And Jesus, and lay thy hand upon them.
Yes.
Upon him, amen.
Yes.
Excuse me. Take Joshua, son of Nun. God already had Joshua planned. Joshua already had his purpose planned,
yes,
amen, for him to lead his people. It says, a man who is the Spirit. Amen, amen, who is of the Spirit. Not a man who used to have the Spirit, not a man who's going to have the Spirit, but a man who already has the Spirit in him. Amen. God needs somebody who has the fruit of his Spirit. Amen. The love, the joy, the peace, the long-suffering, the goodness, the meekness, the kindness, the fruits of his Spirit. Amen.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I know I'm taking over, but
no,
I can feel a word in
amen.
My heart.
She's a leader. Amen.
A word in my soul.
Amen.
It says, a man who is of the Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Who has my Spirit, who is of me, who has been seeking diligently. Amen.
Yes.
Always reading in my word, who is meditating day and night, who knows my spirit, a God-fearing man, amen?
Yes.
And it says in verse 19, and set him before Eleazar, the priest, and before all the congregation, and give him a charge in their sight, amen?
Amen.
The Lord brought Joshua amongst all the people, it says before the congregation, before all the children of Israel, and anoint him, amen? Before it said in verse, hallelujah, Jesus, 18, it says, and lay thy hand upon them, amen, anoint them. What happened, hallelujah, Jesus, when David, amen?
Yes.
When they anointed David, amen, they poured the oil upon his head. They anointed him because he had the Spirit, amen, who is the Spirit.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus, in verse 20, it says, and thou shalt put some of thine honor upon him, that all the congregation of the children of Israel may be obedient. Amen. As I was saying, God is somebody who's going to keep the sheep in the path. Amen. Who's going to make them obedient. Amen.
Yes.
Is there anything that you would like to add?
Amen.
On top of this? Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just one thing that stood out to me was that, amen, I really don't have anything that stands out. Amen. Because, amen, you did such a wonderful job. Amen. We're going over to Isaiah. Amen.
Chapter 55, if you have your Bibles. Amen.
Amen.
Starting at verse 3. Amen.
Amen. I'll read for you. Amen.
Amen.
And that's what happens when a leader shows up. Amen. Everybody gets in order. Amen. Because what did I say? I said I will read for her. Amen. So when you have a born leader, amen, and a person that stands up to lead, amen, everybody will automatically begin to follow. What does that mean? That means that when you have the courage to stand up and say, I'm going to take my rightful place as the leader that God is calling me to be, that means that God will make everything line up behind you. Amen. So I'm going to be a humble servant and I'm going to read. Amen. Isaiah 55 and 3. Amen. Incline your ear and come unto me. Hear, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David. Mm-hmm. Amen. Behold, I have given him for a witness to the people, a leader and a commander to the people. Behold, thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, and nations that knew not thee shall run unto thee because of the Lord thy God, and for the Holy One of Israel, for he hath glorified thee.
Amen. May the Lord have a blessing to the reading of his word. Amen.
Amen.
It's saying, let's break it down if we could. Amen. It says, incline your ear. Amen. What does that mean? That means open up your ears. Amen.
Yes.
Open up your ears and listen to what God is saying. Amen. And come unto me, hear, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even share the mercy of David. Amen.
Yes.
Lord, I have given for him a witness to the people, a leader and a commander to the people. Amen.
Yes.
God says, I have given them, amen,
yes,
a leader, somebody to follow, somebody for them to follow, amen, somebody to have, as she was saying, all their ducks in order, amen.
Yes.
She was saying that when you have God by your side, amen, you're in a group, amen, you're out there, amen, in a group. You, once you have those fruits of the Spirit, you have God on your side, somebody to lean on, they will say, oh, she can be the leader, amen, because, or he can be the leader because I see God on them, amen.
Yeah.
I know that they're going to have me doing the way that we're supposed to go. I'm going to have them have it together, amen, in school.
Yes.
I'm going to have the property one time, we're going to time to present. We're not going to be fumbling around, and we're not going to look, amen, as God, as we were saying, God's not going to have you looking a fool out there, amen.
Amen.
God's going to have you looking together, amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Before I've given him for a witness to the people, a leader and a commander, amen. In the Bible, what does it say? It says, God said, for I have given some apostles, some teachers, some priests, amen, some evangelists, hallelujah, Jesus, some healers, amen, some,
yes,
ministries, hallelujah,
yes,
Jesus.
Yes.
God set out all these leaders, amen, teachers, evangelists, apostles, hallelujah, Jesus, elders,
yes,
deacons, all,
yes,
these people in the church, amen. They are leaders, hallelujah, Jesus, leaders,
yes,
in the kingdom of God, leading God's sheep and his people, amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
Behold, thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, and nations that thou knew not shall run unto thee because the Lord thy God. It's saying, amen, that other,
yes,
people will,
preach,
run, amen. The,
yes,
enemy will flee, hallelujah, Jesus, because you have the Lord, preach, thy God on your side, amen.
Yes.
It says, and for the Holy One of Israel, for he hath glorified thee.
Yes.
It says, amen, it's saying that if you keep God by your side and you lead the way that he wants you to in his will, amen, he will glorify thee, amen. And she,
amen,
was saying, he will make your enemies your footstool, for they will run, amen. Knew,
yes,
that these knew not thee shall run unto thee because the Lord thy God, amen, the Lord that we serve. What kind of God do we serve on a day?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
What kind of God do we serve? We serve a lily in the valley, a bright and morning star. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus, a counselor, a friend. Amen.
Yes.
A rock in a weary land. Hallelujah,
yes,
Jesus.
Preach.
He is,
yes,
the rock. Amen. Hallelujah,
yes,
Jesus. I just feel a time, amen, to glorify God on this. It says, for he hath glorified thee. Amen.
Yes.
So you keep God on your side when you leave on your way. Amen. Whether you may be at work or you may be at school. Amen. Or anywhere that you may be.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus. If you have God on your side, somebody to lean on. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
He will be there and he will glorify thee amongst the people, amongst the group. Hallelujah, Lord. Do you have anything that you would,
amen,
like to add on that?
Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Just the fact that, amen, you're just doing it. I'm here to be a servant today, amen. I really can't say too much, amen. But it's like you said, that when you trust in the Lord and you lean not to your own understanding, and he will direct your path. When you keep God first, he will give you, he said, I give thee the sure mercies of David. Amen. That stood out to me in the other scripture here in verse 55 and 3. He said, and I will make an everlasting covenant with you. That's Isaiah 55 and 3. Even the sure mercies of David. That says a lot right there. The sure mercies of David. Amen. Meaning that the Davidic covenant, amen, which was the covenant of David, amen, God will give you that. God will give you the mercies of David. Why? What did God do? God saved David. Every time David had to go into battle, he went to God and said, God, if you're going to be there for us, let me know, because I'm ready to go to war. And that's another thing that God is looking for in a leader. He's looking for somebody that's ready. He's looking for you to be ready to stand up and say, yes, I send me, I will go. Amen. God is looking to give you the sheer mercies of David. Amen. And he wants you to be ready, because you never know when God may show up and say, now is your season. Now is your time. Right now, not tomorrow, not the day after, but right now is your time, it's your season. So God wants you to be ready in this hour. Amen. Amen. Amen.
If I could speak off of what she was saying about being ready, amen. He wants somebody who is ready, amen. For the Bible says that the people girded up their loins. What does that mean, amen? In the Bible, everybody wore skirts, amen. Everybody wore some type of dress, amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Gird up their loins, amen. They took the middle of their dress and they tied it so that they could run, amen. Yes. We need somebody who's going to run, amen. Who's going to be ready, amen. For I remember, if you can remember, amen, when you were younger, amen, and you would be outside with your friends, amen, you would play, and if you wanted to go to the park, or if you wanted them to spend the night, or if they could come inside and have dinner and say, if I ask her, she'll say no, but if you ask her, she'll say yes, amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. We want somebody who's going to be there, who's not going to say no, but if I go, then they'll say no, but if you go, then they'll say yes, amen. We want somebody who, when God asks, they'll be ready, amen, they'll say yes. 100% amen. We want somebody who is shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, amen.
Yes.
Who has on the breastplate of righteousness, amen.
Yes, say it.
And hallelujah, Jesus. If we could go to that scripture which it says, amen. The scriptures, amen, that say be shod with the preparation of gospel of peace, amen. All the things that God wants you to have, amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus. We're winging it on the day, amen. Hallelujah,
amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
We're saying.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Lord. What is God saying? Man, he wants somebody who's going to be ready. When he says, I need you to lead, say, I will lead, Lord. Not shy saying, oh, I don't know, Lord. They won't listen to me. They don't know, amen. They won't listen to me. They're not going to do what I tell them to do, amen. He wants a leader who's going to stand up, hallelujah, Jesus. Somebody who's going to stand up, who's going to say yes, 100%, amen. Who's going to say yes, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Who's going to say yes to his will and to his way, amen. Ephesians. Chapter 6, verse 13, if you could read that, amen.
Amen. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand thereof, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints.
Amen. Lord, have a blessing. The reading of his word, amen. We're talking about leaders, and this is youth Bible study. So in the youth, amen, we know that at school or wherever we may be in college, amen, that we're in groups all the time, whether we're working on a group project, amen, or a group presentation. In some groups, there's just that always that one person that is always so negative, amen.
Yes.
The person that's always complaining, saying we can't do it, we're not going to be on time. The person that's always lazy, who doesn't want to do any work, they just want to hand it all over to everyone, amen.
Yes.
It says, take the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand, amen. You have on your side, amen, and you have on all these things, the armor of God, amen. Your loins girded with truth, the breastplate of righteousness, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, amen. Then
amen.
You can shun that person, amen. You don't have to listen to them, amen. The negative person that's always, hallelujah, Jesus, negative. They're never thinking of the positive things, no matter.
Yes.
Every time things go bad, they always want to give up and give in the towel, amen. They always want to raise their white flag and say, I surrender. I can't do it, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus. And if you have all these things, amen, it says be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, amen. Those negative people in the group, being a leader, amen, amongst the people, being able to all the fiery darts of the wicked, amen. Think
amen.
About all the leaders, amen. People, not everybody's going to like your allegiance, your leadership skills, because there always be, amen, the enemy somewhere sitting out there, amen. And those and the enemy that's sitting out there in the group that you're trying to lead, that's going to be those fiery darts of the wicked,
say
amen.
It,
those are going to be those negative people that are always saying the bad things, amen.
Yes.
See, this is what I'm talking about. The people of God, amen. We need to be more, we need to open our ears, as they were saying in the scripture, and open our eyes, amen. We need to pay attention to those negative peoples, amen. Those people who are shooting those fiery darts, amen. The wicked people, the negative people, amen. We need to pay attention to those people, amen. We need to pay attention so that we can have the faith, amen. Have on the whole armor of God, amen. To be able, amen, to shut down the enemy, amen.
Yes.
To be able to make them be quiet, to shut them up, amen. So that we can do the purpose of God, amen.
Yes.
It says, praying with all prayer and supplication in the spirit, amen. And when you feel those fiery darts coming, amen, pray for the strength that she was talking about, amen.
Yes.
The fiery darts, it says, pray with all prayer, amen. Not just some prayer, not a halfway prayer, but I'm talking about a full prayer. You know, when you cook dinner, amen, or somebody cooks dinner, or you're at a restaurant and the food just looks so delicious, it's nice and piping hot, it's your favorite food, amen, and you're ready to eat it, amen. They say grace, amen. And when we don't want to wait, amen, we just say, amen, Jesus wept, amen. No, we're not talking about that. Hallelujah. Jesus was saying, pray with all prayer and supplication, amen. Not just a halfway Jesus wept prayer, amen.
Yes.
We're talking about a full prayer, amen, so that we can resist and we can quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Into the spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. That's what I was talking about, people of God. It says, watching thereunto with all perseverance, amen. Watching out for those negative people, amen. If you can scroll down, hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
All those negative people, amen. It says, and for me that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly, amen. What do leaders have to be? They have to be bold, amen. They have to stand up amongst the group, amen.
Yes,
the wayward group that's not going to have it done. They're not going to have, hallelujah, Jesus, the project done on the due date. They're going to have the project halfway. They're not shooting in a group of people who are shooting for C's, who are just shooting, hallelujah, Jesus, for that 70%, amen, that 50%. They're just trying to skim across the top. They're just trying to make it. That leader who will stand out and say, I want to get 100. I want to get an A. I want to give my 110%. Amen.
Yes, yes, yes.
Those people, amen, that may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel. Amen.
Yes.
Who will come out and say, amen, I know that we have God on our side. Amen. I know we may have a couple of setbacks in this project that we are doing. I know that we may not have it done by the due date, but if we could just take time to pray really quick, amen.
Yes.
It says, and with all prayer, amen, as I was saying, not the halfway prayer, Jesus wept, amen, and we're done, amen. I'm talking about a full prayer, amen, hallelujah, Jesus, prayer unto God, asking for him to help us, amen. Is there anything that you would like to add on to that?
Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus, just say that. Amen. Like she said, to open our mouth with boldness. Amen. And it takes a boldness. Amen. For us to open up and stand amongst the crowd. Amen. When I first began to walk in ministry, amen, the mothers of the church would tell me, they would say, you can't lead from the back. Amen. Come on up to the front. Amen. And so to be able to come up to the front means that, amen, that we have to walk in a boldness. Amen. To be bold means that, amen, we're willing to go above and beyond what the normal person would not be willing to do. Amen. And this is that leadership that God desires to birth inside of the youth, inside of the people who are like David, inside of the people who are willing and ready to take on the Goliaths inside of the world. Don't you know that there are Goliaths inside of the world? I mean, we're in the year of 2017, but amen, in the next 20 years, amen, these Davids, they're going to be leading, amen, and there are going to be Goliaths, amen, in the land, and God is looking to birth the boldness out of you now, amen, so that it can be led, amen. There's going to come a time in a season where, amen, I might get tired, amen, and I'm not able to lead anymore, amen, as well as the others, amen. The Bible declares in Ecclesiastes that time and chance happens to every man, amen, meaning that we all get an opportunity, amen, and I believe that God sent us by today to ask you, amen, will you allow the leader to stand up in you? Will you allow that person inside of you that God wants to give the boldness to arise? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. As she was saying, amen, will you let that leader step out into you? Amen.
For
why, amen, why are the youth so important? Why are the youth so important as leader? Amen. as leaders. Amen. Before we got ready to start, amen, the Bible study, we were watching a movie. Amen. It was a Disney nature movie. Amen. It was a documentary. And it was talking about the animals, the young animals. Amen. How all the skills that their parents have are passed down to them, amen? How to hunt for food, how to look for food, how to create shelter, how to hibernate, amen? All these things, amen? These need to be passed down, amen, to the youth, amen? For yes. We hear all the times, amen, in media or in movies or TV shows, we hear that the youth are our future, amen? We are going to be the ones who are going to be older, amen? The ones who are going to have to step up and show, amen? Will you step up and show, amen? Will you amen. Be the banner of Christ today in that group, amen? And yes. That group of those wicked and those negative people, amen? Will you stand up and be the light of Christ, amen? For the word declares that we are to be the salt of the earth. Will you yes. stand up yes. as a leader today and be the salt of the earth? Be the salt in that group. Be the one, the positive one out of all those negative people. Be the one who's going to stand up, who's going to say, I know that it may look bleak now. We've had a couple of setbacks, but we have God on our side, and we have all the armor of God on yes. so that we know that we will make it through with God on our side as someone leaning. Amen?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. As we're saying, amen, a leader, amen, we need somebody to stand up, amen. To stand up and be amen. There in that group, amen, in that flock, amen, in that team, amen.
Amen.
Working together, amen. Guarding the people, guarding the sheep, amen. Yes. What does the Bible say? The Bible says that nobody can learn without a teacher, amen.
Amen.
A teacher. What is a teacher? Amen. As I was saying in the scripture before, amen, as I was saying that in the Bible, it says that God appoints some prophets, some teachers, some apostles, amen. These are leaders. It says a teacher, amen. A teacher, amen. How can the people learn without a teacher, amen? We need a leader, a teacher to come up and stand up and show people the way of God, amen.
Amen.
Show these people the way that they are supposed to go. Tell them to turn back from their wicked ways. For the Bible
yes.
says that if you would humble yourselves and pray and yes. turn from your wicked ways, then shall I heal the land, amen.
Amen.
Then shall I heal the land, amen. We need a leader to stand up and tell the people to turn from their wicked ways, amen.
Yes.
Be humble unto him, amen.
Yes.
We need somebody to come out and say, amen, that God is the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to God except through the Son, amen. We need somebody
yes.
to come up to say, amen, that
yes.
if you confess with your mouth, amen, then you shall be saved, amen. We need
yes.
somebody to come up and be that salt to the earth, amen. We need somebody to come up and say, amen, God is the only way, amen. We need somebody to come up and stand and lead the people, amen. Is there
amen.
Anything that you would like to
amen,
add?
Amen, amen, hallelujah, amen. You know, the Bible declared that, you know, Abraham, when he was tried, amen, he offered up Isaac. He did it by faith. The Bible declares in Hebrews 11 chapter, it says that Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning the things to come. The Bible says that even when Jacob was dying, he blessed both the sons of Joseph in worship, leaning on his staff. Everything that was done by faith. By faith, Joseph, when he died, he made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandment. The Bible says that by faith, when Moses was born, he was hid for 3 months by his parents. Everybody that God called to be a leader inside of the body, inside of the Bible, they did it by faith. Amen. They did those things by faith. Amen. And they were able to lead by faith. Amen. We're not going to see the big picture. You're not going to see the big picture. Amen. But just to respond to the call, as she said about Samuel, amen, when Eli, amen, noticed that, hallelujah, God, Jesus, that God was calling on Samuel, all the only thing he had to do was respond. Amen. And sometimes that's what God is looking for. He's just looking for a response. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. To talk about what she was talking about. Amen. We're getting ready to close. Amen.
Amen.
That, hallelujah, Jesus, we need a leader, somebody to stand up. She was saying that everybody in the Bible, everybody that God called, amen, they had faith. Amen. They had to step out, amen, and have faith. Amen. Have faith that God would lead them, that God would lead them, would have them out there, full, amen.
Amen.
That they would be out there, amen, moving with the word of God, amen, moving and breathing, amen, the word of God, amen, moving the way that God wanted them to for his will, amen.
Amen.
We need godly somebody to carry out his plan, amen?
Yes.
Somebody to carry out his plan, amen? He needs somebody to help him, amen? And who's going to help them, help him, amen? That leader, amen? That salt of the earth, amen? That good one, as we were talking about Noah, amen? Yes. God needed somebody to help him carry out his plan. He couldn't do it by himself, so we called him Noah, the only good one, amen? Say amen. Yes. Some people desire to be leaders, amen? I want to be a leader, amen?
Yes.
Who we find out, amen, we observe children as a young age, amen, and we say, oh, they're going to be a leader, amen. I can tell now that they have this possessiveness, amen, that they have this ability to come over and turn a bad situation into a good one, amen.
Yes.
They have a, they have the ability, amen, to walk in the way that God wants them to do, amen. We observe these children and we say, they're going to be a leader, amen, because I see them, amen. The way that they are now when they are young, they are able to turn bad things into good things, amen.
Yes,
with the help of God on their sides, amen. We need somebody to be a leader. God needs somebody to be on his side. God needs somebody to help carry out his plan. And how can you be a leader on a day, amen? Have on the whole armor of God, as we were talking about in the scripture, amen.
Amen.
Have on that breastplate of righteousness and a helmet of salvation, amen.
Yes.
Having your loins girded with the preparation of the gospel of peace, amen. And your loins girded with the gospel of truth, amen. Somebody out there to be the salt of the earth, amen. Is there anything you'd like to add as we
amen. Close up on the TV? Amen. As we close, it just really stood up how you kept saying that a leader is someone that turns a bad situation into a good situation. Amen. And I know that that's the Holy Spirit revealing that, amen, because, amen, that's what leaders do. Amen. They provide all alternatives. I mean, when you have, amen, leaders inside of corporations, they are great leaders because they know how to get a company from point A to point B. Amen. They know how to move a mass group of people. Amen. And we have a 15-year-old young lady saying that, amen, a leader is someone that knows how to take a bad situation and turn it into a good. We know that that is speaking by the Holy Spirit. Why? Because that's what a leader is. A leader is a person that knows how to give an alternative to make a bad thing good. And it reminds me of Romans 8:28, which says, for all things work together for good, for them who love God, for them who are called. There is that word, called according to his purpose. Let us go over to, amen, Romans 8:28. Just really quick, I just want to show, amen, how that, amen, God is showing that thing that, amen, she just said that, amen, turning a bad situation into a good. Amen, turning something bad into something good. It says in Romans 8:28, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. The Bible says, for whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his son. And so God has predestined you to be a leader. This is why you feel the unction and the urge inside of you to step forward. Amen. Because being a leader is something, it is a gift that God gives to individuals. And leaders cannot be, amen, they can't, leaders cannot be taught to be a leader, but being a leader is something that you're born with, amen. So when you feel the desire to step forward above and amongst the crowd, above everyone else, this is the predestining that God has set up for your life, because he has predestined you to be a leader. He's predestined you to take his vision into great places. He's predestined you to take the glory of God to people that may not hear about the glory of God. God has predestined you to walk in a place of evangelism. God has predestined you to walk in a place of being a leader. Amen. Wherever you are, amen, on tonight. If you're at home, if you're at school, amen, and wherever you are, amen, if you feel the desire to stand up, amen, everybody is not willing to stand up, but if you feel the desire inside of you to stand up, that means that God has called you and gifted you with a leadership capability of a leader. Now listen, this is the question that we have to ask for tonight. If God has called called you to be a leader. Will you lead the people for God, or will you lead the people for the enemy? That's a question that we have to answer. Amen. And the Bible declares that God has given people so many gifts, but I see people with all of these great gifts, but they're using them on the wrong side. Amen. What are you saying on tonight, woman of God? I'm saying that you have to use your gift for God's kingdom. Amen. Because we're here to advance the kingdom. Amen. We're here to use it for the greater good. The Bible says in Romans 8:28 that we know that all things work together for good. Amen. So while God has given you these gifts and these talents, are you allowing them to work together for the good of God's kingdom? Amen. He wants those things to work together for good. Amen. Why? Because a leader is someone, like the minister said, Minister Sierra said, a leader is someone that knows how to take a bad situation and turn it into a good situation. Amen.
Amen. If we could just pray really quickly. We just Amen. Thank you, Lord God, for Hallelujah. Bringing forth your Jesus. Word. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for yes, leading Lord. Us. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, Jesus, yes, for being Lord. There for us, Heavenly Father, being there as we lead, Lord God, Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord God, for showing us your ways, Lord God. We ask that you touch the people right Amen. Now, Lord God, Jesus. Yes. Touch them. Hallelujah, touch Jesus. Them. Help them, Lord God, Jesus. Yes, take that urge you're saying to become a leader. You feel yourself coming up, hallelujah, Jesus, coming out of the crowd, amen, and wanting to be a leader. We ask that you help them, Lord God. Make yes, that urge Jesus. Even stronger than it was before, Lord God, so that they may come out and lead the people in, as your word said, amen, for the good of them that love God according to his purpose, amen. For the good of them, amen, hallelujah, Lord God. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Listen, amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. You got to go, amen. You got to listen to, hallelujah, Jesus, all the other Bible studies that we have. You have to stay connected to us, amen. It says, amen, on the caption, amen, the prophetichouse.org, hallelujah, Jesus. Come there. You can hear more about us in the About Us tab, about amen. Apostle Allyssa, about us, amen. Contact us if you need prayer, amen. We've been your hosts. I've been your host, Sierra Narvaez, and Apostle Allyssa. Narvaez, amen.
Amen.
And we thank you, amen, for coming and listening to us and being here. Amen. For we know that we saw fit for you to be here, amen. For God saw fit for you to be here listening here. Amen. Maybe you're listening there and you felt that urge that she was talking about, that amen. Urge to be a leader, amen. That amen. Urge to stand up in front of the people, hallelujah. Amen. An urge to stand up, hallelujah, amen. Jesus, hallelujah. To stand up.
Amen.
Amongst the crowd, as she was saying amen. When she first became amen. A leader, amen, that you can't lead from the back, amen.
Amen.
You cannot lead from the back, amen. And we amen. Thank you for listening and tuning into us on this evening. May amen. God bless you and keep you on your way and throughout your day.
Amen. God bless you.